Happy to be here, Leilani, at Mimo Market. It's been such a long time, right? It's been over 2 years.
Yes, it has. And lots changed.
I know. You guys are still going strong. You moved in a new location.
Yes.
Kind of extended.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit, back when you guys started, why did you guys pick the fashion industry?
Well, Lisa and I both have been in the industry for a long time. We went to school for it, and we kind of started off in editorial, working for corporate, and we would always kind of daydream, talk about, oh, we should do our own boutique one day and not work for the man anymore.
Isn't that any girl's, young girl's dream, kind of?
And we saw actually opportunity here. We would visit, and we just felt like there was opportunity to have like a new concept of a boutique here. And then we just kind of decided to take the leap go for it little by little.
I'm sure you guys had also a lot of challenges on the way.
Yes, for sure, a ton.
Talk to me about that a little. Like, tell me a few of them.
Yeah, some were like, there's parts of the industry that we weren't familiar with, like real estate and contracts. Mm-hmm. You know, they're like 50 pages long, and you know, reading a contract.
Did you guys hire a lawyer?
We did, and that's another thing. You definitely invest in good help.
Yes,
we learned that the hard way. Because, yeah, we were just weren't familiar with that industry and that market, so we just found it really challenging dealing with people and the verbiage and everything. But we figured it out, thankfully, but that was definitely a huge challenge for us.
Yeah. Online store or brick and mortar store? What's the
both pros challenge? And cons. Mm-hmm. I love brick and mortar just because I love the traditional, like walking into a store and having an experience. I think it's harder to have that full experience online.
Right.
When you walk into a boutique, it's just like you smell, you see, you touch, you see the product, the energy. You can't really get that online. Online's definitely a huge opportunity, but for us, brick and mortar was really important because we love that experience you have in a boutique.
Right.
Yeah.
Any advice you have for anyone who would like to venture off into opening an online store or a boutique, brick and mortar boutique, clothing especially?
Yeah. Definitely develop a business plan.
Okay.
You learn it in college, and sometimes I know I thought, I was like, I'm never going to use this, but when it came down to it, it helped a lot.
Did.
Yeah, it really helped us shape who we are, what we wanted to have, our financials, how much do we need to prepare. It just helps you kind of streamline your thoughts because you get a lot of things coming at you, and you're like, oh, I want to do this, I want to do this, and then when you put it on paper, you're like, this doesn't make sense. I need to like streamline this.
Right.
So definitely that. And also, you know, prepare for the unexpected. A lot of unexpected things happen and it can really get you down, but you have to just stay strong throughout the process and to not give up, whether it's online or in store. Things are always going to come up that you don't foresee. But you just kind of have to get through it, learn from it, and grow from it, and just stick it out because you'll have a lot of moments of like, why am I doing this? You know what I mean? Like, it gets crazy.
Yeah, I think it's any business.
You're like, why am I doing this?
And sometimes it's good, I guess, if you have a partner as you do.
Yes,
right?
For
a business partner to help each other go through.
Yeah.
And I guess that's why you guys are still standing strong and
have
an even bigger location. You guys went through all the challenges.
We
just
did.
Stick through it and move forward.
Yes. Where there's a will, there's a way.
Exactly.
So I definitely tell everybody, like, stick through it, push through it. It makes you stronger, you grow, and you learn a lot about yourself.
Yeah. I also have a question about the panda hats. You guys, that's like a signature for the store.
For
and
sure.
I definitely feel like that's like a genius thing. Genius, like a trademark. I don't even know how to call it.
And we didn't even foresee it, to be quite honest. We just thought we wanted to do something different and fun. You know, it's Wynwood, it's supposed to be creative and funky, and just regular mannequins are kind of boring, you know? So we wanted to dress it up and do something different, and it ended up being way more popular than
because everybody's recognizing basically the store with the panda hats.
And especially after our move, people were like, I saw the panda hats, and we know it's you guys, and I was like, thank God.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Leilani.
Thank you.
You guys have to come check them out here in Wynwood. If you're living in Miami or if you're visiting Miami, definitely look out for the panda hats in the window. I'm excited for the festival season outfits.
Yes.
show me around.
A lot of music festivals coming up. Yeah. A lot of people shopping for spring fashion, things to wear to these festivals. Mm-hmm. So definitely a classic would be a head-to-toe denim look.
Yes.
Denim going back, you know, thinking Woodstock, you know, 70s vibe. We have this denim skirt with a little bit of, like, you know, distressed accents on it. This paired with a head-to-toe here, like the jacket.
Yeah,
super,
definitely.
Super cute.
I'm definitely a denim person.
Yeah, it's good to layer, take on and off.
Cool.
We also have these really cute kind of like springtime
flowers.
Yeah, flower prints. So right now, it's so cute to pair this with like a cute pair of sneakers.
Mm-hmm.
Be comfortable because you're standing outside a lot in these concerts.
Yeah.
But it's bright and fun. Easy.
Definitely. You'll stand out with colors like that.
Absolutely. And then we also got in a lot of crop tops. These crop tops, yes, you can pair with a high-waisted jean or high-waisted skirt, some shorts to keep cool, but it's super easy and keeps you, nice and
cool,
and hot.
And sexy in Palm Springs.
Yeah,
huh?
Exactly.
For those go to Coachella. The really cool part about your store is that you not only have women fashion, you also have guys fashion. And I see a lot of prints here, a lot of color, a lot of Hawaii.
Super Miami style here.
Very much Miami style.
Hipster Miami guy. We wanted to have stuff for the guys too. There's definitely opportunity for it. And guys love fashion too. They want to dress up. Sometimes my husband dresses better than I do. We definitely wanted to incorporate that into the store.
Yeah.
There's a lot of fun things, especially for the upcoming festival season, or just in general for spring. A lot of these fun prints.
Right.
We have like what's really big right now.
The 90s are back.
Yes, are coming back. A lot of these button downs. We have a cotton one. We have one that's a little bit softer, kind of that vintage feel. Pairing these with jeans, your funky sneakers,
shorts.
Yeah, shorts, and you're ready to go.
Yeah. Definitely.
Ooh.